One way repeated measure of ANOVA in STATA. This is STATA data file, and with this data I will perform one way repeated measure of ANOVA. Now this is first column. This is actually the respondent. So we have total 1462 respondent, and I want to see the impact, whether the impact of the particular medicine significantly differ between different time points on the weight gain. So as a researcher, I want to see the impact of a particular medicine on the respondent at different time point. So this medicine is for the weight gain, and if you see the first respondent, so this is their first respondent, and this is three time point, so month. So after giving the medicine, I want to see what is their weight gain. So this, for this first respondent, in the first month their weight is 42 kilogram after giving the medicine, and then in the second month their weight has increased to 50, and in the third month their weight gain is 53 kilogram. So in the similar way, we have put our data to show the weight gain according to the different month after using the medicine for the different respondent. And you see the for different time point, right? So I didn't change the respondent. So this respondent remains the same for different time points. Okay, now to perform the repeated measure of one-way ANOVA, in the command box I have to type ANOVA weight, and right, so this is their weight value, and then I have to put a sample ID or respondent ID, which is actually respondent in my case, and I want to show the differences in the weight according to different month. So next is that I have to put that factor, which is actually month, and then I have to put comma, and I have to write repeated, and this repetition has occurred in three different time points, right? So my repetition is according to the month, so repeated, and in the bracket I put month. Now if I press enter, and then you see that it doesn't show the result, rather it is showing that match size 2 is small. In that case, you need to increase your match size. So in my case, I am just increasing match size up to 10,000. You can increase this up to 11,000 in STATA 13. So if I write set match size 10,000, then it will increase my match size. Now again, I will rerun this same command, ANOVA, and this is the weight and respondent, month, repeated month according to the defined variable, right? And if I press enter, then it will show you result. But if you look at this down here, you see the circle here. That means it is actually calculating. It depends on the memory of your computer and how much memory have you allocated for the STATA. So it may take up to 5 to 7 minutes, so depending on the speed and memory of your computer. Now I got the result, so it takes about 3 minutes. So it depends how much observations have you in your data file, and also, as I said earlier, what is your memory size. Anyway, now how can we interpret this table? So you see, I want to see whether this weight, this actually significantly differ between different time points. Now if I look at the month one from this table, and the p value is statistically significant because it is less than 1% or even 0.01%. That means the weight after getting the medicine, the weight significantly differ according to different time points, according to three time points we have in our data, right? And this table, I think before explaining this table, what you need to do, you need to perform the Mosley's test for sphericity. And if there is a violation in the Mosley's test of sphericity, then we can use the p-value from this table. Okay, now you need to install Mosley because it is not built in command in the STATA. So you need to type ssc install and then Mosley. And it is saying that I have already installed that in my software, so I don't need to reinstall that. But in your case, it is not installed previously, it will be installed. Okay, now after installing this, what you need to do, you need to type xtset and your sample or respondent ID, that is actually your respondent. Okay, press enter. And then you have to type Mosley, Mosley, the value that is actually weight, and M, and the time point, that is month. Okay, so in the bracket, I'll put month, press enter. Now you will get the result for the Mosley's test of sphericity, and you see the p-value is statistically insignificant or statistically not significant because it's actually 1, and it is good because if your p-value is not significant, that means there is no violation of the sphericity. So that is good for you. However, if there is a violation, then you have to use the p-value from this table. That means since my Mosley's test of sphericity is not violated, so I can use the p-value that is from the first table. Otherwise, I have to explain the F and P value based on this table. So if there is a violation of the Mosley's sphericity, then we can use the greenhouse gasser one. Okay, so from this table we can use the p-value. Okay, but in our case I said because this says that the p-value is non-significant, that means there is no violation of the historicity assumption. Okay, now finally if I want to see the mean difference of these three time point for the weight, I can type tab stat and then weight. Is your value, and then statistics, and this statistics we are trying to find out the mean difference between these three time point for the weight. And if you can type by, and then by what, by three different time point, that is actually in my case month. And if you press enter, so you can see the result from here. So you see that after giving the medicine in the first month, the weight is 53 kilo, and then it has increased to the year 2, 54, and year 3 it is in the month second 54, and in the month 3 58. That means gradually it has increased, right? So, and this difference is statistically significant. Okay, so in this way we can perform a repeated measure of one-way ANOVA in the STATA.